Good morning, everybody. My name is Frank Retief, and I'm speaking to you from the beautiful town of Amanus, near to the city of Cape Town. I want to speak to you about lockdown living, but before I do, here's a beautiful song that I hope will be a blessing and a help and an encouragement to you.
Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. There is no shadow of turning with thee. Thou changest not, thy compassion they fail not. As thou hast been, thou forever will be. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto thee.
Springtime and harvest, sun, moon, and stars in their courses above. Join with all nature in manifold witness to thy great faithfulness, mercy, and love. Thine own dear presence to cheer and to guide. Strength for today and right on for tomorrow. Blessings all mine with 10,000 beside. Oh,
morning by
I saw a headline recently about living in lockdown, which said that if you want to be happy living in lockdown, what you ought to be doing is watching your favorite sports film, or baking or your favorite bread, or escaping to mountains and oceans and other exotic places via the wonderful documentaries one can see on TV today. Well, that may be very nice to do and all good and well, but life is very different for most of us under lockdown. Life is hard, and in these days it's even claustrophobic. It's depressing, and we do not have much to look forward to. At least most people today don't have much to look forward to, and many families are under severe strain. I'd like to read to you my Bible verse for today. It comes from Romans chapter 12, and it is verse 9, and this is what it says. Let love be genuine. Abhor what is evil. Hold fast to what is good. That's not a very complicated verse, and it's easy to remember. And I'd like to remind you of what it says by pointing out to you its three main words. And the first word is this. It's simply the word love. Let your love be genuine, it says. Let your love be without dissimulation. Let your love be real. Let your love be without hypocrisy. It's the opposite of hypocritical, superficial love that many people express today. You know how we are as human beings. Often we end a phone call by saying, I love you. Or we hug each other when we say goodbye to each other saying, I love you. And in a second or two, that face is gone. But what the Apostle Paul is telling us to do here is to love each other genuinely as Christian believers, and to care about each other, to care about our world, and to care about other human beings. And so we've got to love each other with absolute sincerity. And there should be no pretense in our love for each other. We need to remember that love covers a multitude of sins, which means that if you really love each other, then you don't take notice of all of the little faults in the other person. You don't hold them to account for it, or raise it to them, or throw it in their face all the time, like many of us tend to do. And we're more tempted to do that now under our repressive living conditions than we are normally when we are free to walk around. So, your family may be struggling, and you may be battling to keep relationships good and free. And may I remind you then what it says in Ephesians 4 verse 32. Be kind to one another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, as God in Christ forgave you. And that's how we ought to be living in lockdown. We ought to be living with that kind of love for each other. And why don't we do that? If you say that you're a Christian, why don't you live like that? Why don't you actually do that instinctively and naturally? Why do you have to be exhorted to do that all the time? We need to know that as Christians, we need to be reaching out to each other, understanding that our time in history is a difficult time. And the phase that we're going through right now is difficult for all of those in our households. So let's learn to be patient and kind. Let's have a genuine kindness that comes from our faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Not a simulated kindness, not a hypocritical type of kindness or gentleness or love, but something that is deeply rooted in a faith in a deep and a wonderful Savior. And so I ask you to remember this word. It says love, and love without dissimulation, love without hypocrisy, love without any sort of hesitation. Let it be rooted in the Lord Jesus Christ. But there's another word that the Apostle Paul points us to in this one little text. It says, abhor that which is evil. We don't use that word abhor too much today, but it means to hate something. And what he's suggesting we do is just to hate evil. Now, of course, in our wider society, we are expected to hate all forms of evil, and many people do today. We thank God for the many people who are involved in fighting so many of the social evils in our world today. We have all of the social evils set before us on a regular basis in the media. And there are many, many people who join all sorts of NGOs and all sorts of volunteer groups and all sorts of action groups to fight against ingrained racism or poverty or inequality or trafficking. And we thank God for all of that. But while we are now in this situation, what we need to remember is that this still holds true for us on a sort of microscopic level. There's a macro way in which we abhor evil, but there's a micro way in which we abhor evil. So while we're all locked down together, we've still got to hate all the things that are wrong. And so therefore we make sure that our lives, while we are locked down, are lives that reflect the Lord Jesus Christ. Now what we're hearing today is that while people are locked down, there are all kinds of things that are happening in many homes today, not least of which is abuse. And we want to stand against that. We want to look at our hearts and say to ourselves, are we guilty of abuse in any way? We read about violent abuse. We read about protections that need to be put into place for women and children, because everybody locked down, especially those who live in small houses or small homes, they can't put up with the claustrophobia of living together. And so tensions develop and tempers are short, and sooner or later someone lashes out. Now that may not be true of you. You may be fortunate enough to live in a different situation, and it may not be something that you do yourself. Nevertheless, we are all tempted to be short-tempered and short-fused during days like this. And we're all tempted to be abusive, if not physically, in other ways, by the way we talk to each other, by the way we speak, by the way in which we insult each other, or by sulking, or by withdrawing, or by living with conflict and tension all the time while we're in the situation. Stop it. Don't do it anymore. It's not what you ought to be doing if you say you're a believer in the Lord Jesus Christ. We are to abhor that which is evil. You know, one of the great theologians of old said this: we are accountable to God for the state of our minds as well as our external conduct. So the way you are, your moodiness, the things that go through your minds, all of those things are part and parcel of what God takes note of. We are accountable to God for what goes on in our minds as well as what happens in our lives. So let's steer clear of what is evil in our homes. Let's steer clear of all the wrong things that we can pick up on our screens and on our devices. Let's remember that we are to abhor evil and to be who we say we are. We are Christians, so let's be Christians. And then there's one last word that the Apostle Paul gives us in this one little verse, which is so good for us to remember. He says, hold fast to what is good. Hold fast to what is good. In other words, don't let go of all the good things. Hang on to it. Don't let it slip from your mind. Don't let it slip from your conscience. Don't let it slip from your behavior. Hold fast to what is good. Insist on it. Dig your heels in and say, I will do what is good. I will be what I'm supposed to be as a Christian. Now look, I'm not suggesting that all of us can be perfect. I don't suggest that for 1 minute. I know that we all make our mistakes. We all slip up from time to time. But we know where we can go for forgiveness. And we know that we can be renewed. We know that we can be reconciled. We know how to say sorry. We know how to put things right with each other and how to be reconciled to each other. But nevertheless, the basic tenor and tone of our lives should be rooted in the Lord Jesus Christ. And there it should be established forever, so that even our minds are open, who are open to God, we'll have no fear of what he sees going on in our minds. Hold fast to what is good and be courteous to each other and be good to each other, and ask God for help to help you to be that sort of person. But hang on a second, I've been speaking to Christians, but it may well be that you have tuned into this particular service and you're not a committed Christian. You may be sympathetic, or someone's persuaded you to check in with us, but you may not be a committed Christian like I'm speaking about. What about you? Who do you go to for rules? Who do you go to for principles? Where do you go for some sort of rock upon which you can stand? You know, nothing out there in the world keeps its promises. All of the things that the media promises you doesn't come true. All the things that promiscuity promises you doesn't come true. Happiness doesn't come to you through those means. Joy doesn't come to you through those means. You know, if you are not a Christian, there's nothing out there in your world that is stable or that can keep his promises to you. There's only one person who can keep his promises to you, and that is the Lord Jesus Christ, who promises forgiveness and life for those who put their faith and trust in Him. And with that comes a new nature so that you can read life differently, react differently, and live differently. So if you lock down and you are frustrated and you don't know what to do and you don't know what to think and you don't know what to do with yourself and you don't know what to make of the world and you're feeling depressed and without hope and you're feeling empty inside, the place to go to is to the cross. Go to the Lord Jesus Christ. Ask Him to forgive your sins and accept you, make Him part of your family so that you can receive the power to live like you ought to live during lockdown. You don't know how to do that? Let me suggest a little prayer that you can pray. It will appear on your screen. Use it right now. Say it in your heart to God. Almighty God, I present myself to you today with a deep sense of inner need. I am a sinner, and I have lots of worries and fears. I believe you sent Jesus to earth so that He could make it possible for me to know you and be part of your family. I understand He died on the cross to pay for my sins and obtain forgiveness for me. Please forgive me in Jesus' name. Take me into your family. Help me to live for you. Be with me in all my cares. I give myself to you. Amen. Now, if you've prayed that prayer, now what I'm suggesting you do is tell someone what you have done. And once you've told someone what you have done, why don't you contact the address that appears on your screen right now and ask for further help to know how to be a Christian. God bless you.